Hey all, welcome to Kiran Prajapati channel.
Hello students, today we are going to see problems on DFA and NDFA equivalence. So for every NDFA there exists an equivalent DFA. So how it is going to be constructed, right? So the procedure for the same we are going to see it now. So the question would be like, construct a deterministic finite automaton, that is a DFA, which is equivalent to this NDFA, and the NDFA is given as M equal Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3, 0, 1, delta, Q0 and Q3. This is the states the NDFA is having. This is a sigma transition function, Q0 initial state, and this is the final state, and the delta is given as like this. So as we know that NDFA means, on taking some input, the state where it is going to transition, it is not determined. That is the reason we call it as NDFA. So here Q0 initial state, on taking a input, it may either go to Q0 or it may go to Q1. Okay, so this is a table for our NDFA. As you can see, Q is Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3. Four states are there. So the number of states is 4. And if I say 2 raised to Q, that is equal to 2 raised to 4 equal to 16 states. So I can have 16 substates. From this 4 states, I can construct 16 substates. So for an NDFA, the transition function is Q into sigma, that is mapping to 2 raised to Q. So it takes the state and the input, and it can map to any of the 16 states. So that is what is the meaning over here. Now this is a given NDFA. We are going to construct a DFA for the same. Okay, so let my DFA be M1, which will be given by this tuple, 2 raised to Q, A comma B, sigma, Q0 and F. Why 2 raised to Q? Because here we are going to have subsets of Q. As our transition function is going to map into 16 states, so all the 16 states we are not considering over here. We are just going to consider some substates of Q, and which states we are going to consider is whichever states are reachable from Q0. Those states we are going to consider in our table. So here total we can have 16 states. But we are not going to consider all 16 states. It will be some substates that we are going to consider. And this is sigma A comma B. The initial state is Q0. As you can notice here, when I write DFA, the states would be written in square bracket, as it is symbolizing that it is a single state. And then the F. F is the final state ka set. Okay. So here Q0 is the final state. So wherever in the 16 subsets, Q3 is the final state. So wherever in the 16 subsets, wherever Q3 is going to come, all those are going to be the part of the final state. So for example, Q3, Q0, Q3, Q1, Q3, Q2, Q3 and so on. Okay, so that constitutes my final state. So you have to write what is your DFA machine, what the tuple is going to be, what can be the possible set of finite states, and what is going to be your delta. Okay, so I have drawn a table for delta. So here I am going to start with Q0 as it was the initial state. Go to Q0, see what is the results for A and B. So here the results for A and B are Q0, Q1 and Q0. I write the same as it is. Okay, now what is the idea over here is, whatever new state you are seeing in this input columns, or you can say the next states column. These are the next states column, or you can say the input columns. Okay, so whatever new state you are going to see, just give an entry to that new state in your present state. Okay, so here as I can see, Q0 Q1 is a new state that is appearing. So I'm going to write it like this. So now it is Q0 Q1. So I am going to look at Q0 and Q1 and union whatever the states are there. So let's look at Q0 Q1. Just union these two. So it is Q0 Q1 Q2 Q0 Q1. I'm going to write the same. Q0 Q1 Q2 Q0 Q1. Now is any new state appearing in this column? Yes, this is a new state I have encountered. So I am going to write this state in my present state ka column. So it is Q0 Q1 Q2. I am going to see all the three and then do the union. So I see all the three and do the union. So that comes up Q0 Q1 Q2 Q3 Q0 Q1 Q3. Let's check Q0 Q1 Q2 Q3 Q0 Q1 Q3. Again I can see that these two states are also new, so I am going to make an entry of the same in my next column, in my present column, and then again union the things and just write it. So as I write this part till here, this part, I can see that now no new state is coming. So I just terminate it. You are going to go on continuing until you are going to see new states coming over here. You are going to add the new states on the present state ka column. And when you see that no new states is coming, as I can see for here, it is Q0, Q1, Q2 and Q0, Q1, Q2. So Q0, Q1, Q2 is already there here. So I am able to see that there is no new states. So I just terminate at this point. So this is the transition table for my DFA. These are some of the examples for practice where your M is given as Q1, Q2, Q3, Sigma, Delta, Q1 and the final state is Q3. This is a NDFA that is given. And whatever the delta is there, it is not given in the tabular format as it was given earlier. So it is given by this delta functions. So you will have to make a table saying this. Okay, you have to make a table saying this, and then you can start constructing the equivalent DFA. So this is one of the way the question can be. Table won't be given, delta functions are given. So just make a table out of it and you can start the procedure. Or say for example, construct a DFA equivalent to NDFA like this. So this is the NDFA that is given, right? So the transition graph is given, transition system is given. You draw a transition table and then you can start. So diagram is given, draw a table and start. And transition functions are given in this way, draw a transition table and start. Or sometimes it would be directly a table is given. Okay, so happy practicing to you. Just solve these answers whether you are able to do or not, and let me know in the comment.